There are so many reasons why a business will fail and other business will succeed. But today we'll be looking at just two reasons why a business will fail or why you are not making sales in your business. Let's take for an example. John loves martial arts very well. He just came back from the city where he learned martial arts. And for the love he has for martial arts, he has decided to start up a business where he will teach people on how to do martial arts. He traveled down to the village where he thinks that people will love martial arts. And for 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, no one even steps into his shop to say, "Hey, hi, what are you selling?" This is a typical example of businesses that are selling what people don't need. Another example, Paul is someone who just learned how to barb people's hair. Then he opens his own shop. But the area where he opened the shop, where he started his own business, is filled with barber shop already. Except Paul has a different approach, a different strategy. Do you think he will make sales in that kind of location, in that kind of condition? Of course not. He won't, because there are already people doing that. It's like the market is already saturated. And if he doesn't bring in a different approach or a different style, or a more advanced skill, he won't make sales at all. Now, from the story I just told you, you can pick out two reasons why businesses are not making sales. First, it's because you're selling what people don't need. You're selling what people don't want. And two, because the market is already saturated and you don't have any special skills, you don't have anything to attract people to you. I just purchased a course that taught me how to pass my JAMB examination. I want to promote it to my Facebook friends. Let's say, for example, my Facebook friends are just newly married women who don't have kids that are in secondary school. They are more interested in either starting up a business or making money online or getting a job too. Now, imagine me selling to them a course that will help their future children pass their JAMB without even knowing whether they've given birth to a child or not. Do you think that market will sell? Do you think that market will sell? This is an example of selling what people don't want. And that is why in every business, you have to do your research very well before setting out to sell to anybody. Now, moving over to the solutions, here's how you can start making sales. Number one, you have to find out what people on your list, who your friends or people around that area that your business is situated, what is this they want? Go out and find the perfect audience for the product you are selling. Now, for my JAMB course, if I still want to continue selling that course, then I have to go out there and look for people that will buy that course. It's either I go out there and find the perfect audience that I want, add them to my friend list and make that offer to them. Or I change my approach or I change my product and sell what my current audience wants. And for the newbies, I have something for you. Watch the video showing on the screen right now where I share my mistakes as a newbie and how I corrected the mistake